Now, a few short questions on edge detection algorithm. Edge detection, are the edge detectors high pass or low pass? So, they are high pass operators. The edges, they correspond to the, or the changes is corresponding to the high frequencies. Do the edge detector increase or not the noise in the image? They increase the noise. For example, the Laplacian operator, Laplace operator, that orders, that performs a second order differentiation, that will immensely increase the noise also. That is sensitive to noise. What is, or where is the edge direction necessary? In order to detect lines having various directions, the edge direction is important. What are the disadvantages of Laplace operator as we have just seen? It is very sensitive to the noise. So the Laplacian operator increases the noise in an image. So it detects also erroneous image, especially in area with low covariances. Edge thresholding. How can we choose the threshold T such that, for example, 5% of the pixel of the output of the detector lie above the threshold? So we calculate the histogram of the detector output values. Then we set the threshold at the point where only the 5% of the output pixels have values greater than the threshold. Half transform. Why model 542 is preferred than the 541? Because this 541 can detect vertical lines also. What problems do we have if the accumulator array say P(a,b) has a big size? Of course, the complexity in computation and memory will be increased. What problems do we have if P(a,b) has a small size? The detection accuracy is reduced. What problems we may have when using Huff transform to finding the circle parameters? The 3D parameter space is needed for a circle detection. So the computational complexity in terms of time and space will increase. Edge following algorithm. What is the meaning of limitation in the equation 551, 553? Generally, the edges and the lines in the image tend to have low curvature. So edge following algorithms take into action this property. We know these equations, there are certain mathematical equations. Why is dynamic programming used in edge following algorithms? Dynamic programming in edge following algorithms. The fundamental observation underlying the dynamic programming is that any optimal path between two nodes of a graph has optimal subpath for any node lying on it. Thus, the optimal path between two nodes can be split into two optimal subpaths for x, this xi lying in the optimal path between xa and xb. So, dynamic programming approaches split the optimization into n independent optimization steps. Let me come to image segmentation algorithms. What is the definition of pixel neighborhood? So, in many applications, it is important to check the connectedness of a region, something that is done using the neighborhood definition. What is the definition of region connectedness? A region R is connected if any two pixels xa, xya and xb, yb belonging to R can be connected by a path xa, ya, xi minus 1, yi minus 1 till xb, yb. So whose pixel this xi, yi belong to R, and any pixel xi, yi is adjacent to the previous pixel xi minus 1 and yi minus 1, and the next pixel is xi plus 1, yi plus 1 in the path. Image segmentation by thresholding. What problem occurs when the histogram has only one lobe? When the image histogram has only one lobe, then the threshold cannot be found. What problems occur when the image has low luminance? The histogram of the image is restricted to a small region of luminance intensity and the uniform thresholding does not give good result. What are the advantages of non-uniform thresholding? The non-uniform thresholding solves this problem since it first modifies the histogram in order to be better distributed in all luminance values. Split and merge and region growing algorithm. What are the advantages and disadvantages if we use more than one seed in a growing technique? By using more than one seed, we expect a better segmentation of an image, better segmentation. Since more seeds lead to more homogeneous region. On the other hand, the probability of splitting the homogeneous region, into a more segment, it also increases. What are the characteristics of non-homogeneous region? The luminance value that have great standard deviation value. What are the disadvantages of split method? The possible creation of neighboring and homogeneous regions that are not connected. And besides this, this method does not preserve small regions and contours also. And the regions that are created have visible square shape. And a large number of regions are created since connections are not allowed. What are the disadvantages of split and merge approach? Split and merge. The disadvantage is that it does not preserve the core tree structure. And besides, this method does not preserve small areas and contours. So, this region that are created have visible square shape. Relaxation algorithm and region analysis. How can we define the initial probabilities of the confidence weight of each pixel in an area? The initial probability of a pixel to belong to a region to belong to a region is usually defined as the inverse of the difference between the luminance value and the region's arithmetic mean of the luminance values. What are the disadvantages of the relaxation algorithm? The efficiency of the method is strongly dependent on the selection of compatibility functions. So if they are wrongly selected, it is possible to lead to algorithm instability. Corrected component labeling. How can we define or find the number of objects in a binary image? First, a connected component is detected in an image, then it is subtracted from the image, then the algorithm is reapplied until no object can be found. What are the disadvantages of recursive algorithm as FIRE algorithm? The need of iterative local operations increases the computational time of the algorithm. How can we find the number of objects in a gray level image? First, the image should be converted into binary image because using a threshold or some other segmentation model. Then a connected component algorithm can be applied. Texture description. What are the advantages and disadvantages of use of histogram for the texture description? The main advantage is the computational simplicity of the algorithm. The main disadvantage, it cannot describe the local textural characteristics. Do we expect small or long run lengths in natural images of objects? Just assuming that natural images have great luminance changes, we expect more small run lengths. What is the information provided by black horizontal run lengths in a binary text image? For the black horizontal run length distribution, we can extract information regarding the size of the text characters. What is the information provided by the white horizontal run lengths in a binary text image? Now, from the white horizontal run length distribution, we can extract information regarding the distance between the text characters. What is the type of autocorrelation function of an image with finite texture? If the texture is fine, the drop-off rate is large. What is the type of autocorrelation function of an image with coarse texture? If the texture is coarse, the drop-off rate is small. What is the type of power spectrum of an image with coarse texture? A coarse texture image has more power in low frequency. So these were a few, very short questions that we come across. Thank you so much. Take care.